to come to pray for you. Just to touch you. If I didn't touch you, don't even live here without being touched. Are you hearing me? Let me show you. Come. Where is your church?
In Lotus Gardens. Lotus.
Is it the first time you are coming?
No. Since.
I want to show you that it's only the touch that can change the ministry. Even when you are not anointed, you can be anointed because someone touched you. Where's your ministry?
It's in Davidton.
Because somebody touched you, you are anointed. Where's your ministry?
Bloemfontein.
Bloemfontein, there's a problem. Where is your ministry?
Soweto.
Yourself, this thing must happen to you. The demon must leave you. Let's go there with the mic. Let's go there. There's a demon. Where's your ministry? Your ministry is here. You are the signs I don't know. Where's your ministry?
Amanskara.
Where's your ministry? No one I prayed for. Pray for Hebrew. Hebrew. Listen, some of you. Where's your ministry?
Skin.
Huh?
Skin him.
I can't hear anything. I want to pray for you for a minute. What is your ministry?
Skin him.
You've been.
Yes.
Johannesburg.
No. No. Jesus.
Commit suicide.
Yes.
You must commit suicide.
Where's your wife?
Yes.
Where's the wife?
In Yuva.
Yuva. Where's your ministry?
It must not go.
Hilbro.
Hilbro.
It must not go.
Same place.
No.
Yes.
There's a lot of problem in the body of Jesus Christ. No one will solve this except. Where is the ministry?
To Sudan. Come to Sudan.
Sudan?
Yes.
Ouch. Already come, but I've prayed for you.
Ouch! Jesus. Ouch!
One of our problems is. Tell you.
Jesus. Jesus. Ouch!
One of our problems is this. Is we are not ready to receive. That's our main problem. When you come to a place like this, you hide your demon, and that demon will just find a place, can leave you and wait for you. We are not ready to receive. This is one of the problems in ministries. I've been praying for pastors. Pastors, I can deliver everyone, but I need the grace of God from you. But if you don't have the grace, I can't deliver you. Don't you understand what I'm trying to say? So the grace is, God must teach you to avail yourself to that anointing. You can still be here, whereas you are home. Do you know why we don't grow? Because of the little things we know. Once you have got certificate of mathematics, does not mean that you are educated. There is geography. So, most of the time, we don't cry to God and say, Lord, I need to be delivered. Because no one has to be proud of I can deliver someone. You need grace. grace. I need grace for you to deliver you. I'm sure you hear me now.
Amen.
I'm not speaking with him, I'm speaking with pastor. I need grace. I'm telling you now. If you can still be here in Charis and the demon is on top of you, you repeat the same mistake. Why? Because you are holding yourself or your position. But if you take your position aside, you say, Lord, I need grace. God will honor you. He will show you where you are wrong. There's no one perfect before God. Everybody needs deliverance. I don't know if you're hearing me. So when I'm praying with you, I've been praying with many pastors, to be honest. And I feel I've got to cry. You hear me? I've got what? One of my cries is, you people here, if you come here, you ask God for grace to be delivered, you'll be delivered. There's no one, even in the Hebrews 11, the people who had enough faith, the Bible says they've died seeing the promises. You cannot finish the promises of God in your life. It's too much. But also you can limit those promises. You can limit. You can still be saying, I'm a man of God. With this gift, you call it. But you don't receive this one. Why? Because this one is working to bring a limit to this one. But if you say, oh, I want to be delivered. I want this also. You know what you will do? Can I tell you? When you come here, you say, God, give me the grace. I want to be in a position of receiving. God will show you a spirit of your family. Everybody needs deliverance. There's a curse in your family. You were born under a curse. You are chosen from a curse. Don't you understand that? So I want to congratulate you. You came here. But I'm worried that you don't need to go with this spirit that is limiting you. I'm sure you're hearing me. I'm sure you're hearing me. You must not go home with the spirit of limiting you. Christmas is around the corner. There's a spirit that's limiting you. The way you entertain Christmas is the way you were defeated or the way you overcome. So what you do now, you go back, you say, no, why I came here and whereas I'm not open to receive? Why waste your time coming here and you close all the doors so that you must not receive? I'm sure you hear me now. Eh? Like myself, if I come to a man of God, what I do, I just say, I don't care whether he prophesied me or not. If he touch me, I know what I received. You hear me? So, one of the problems is, you are coming, but the problem is, your doors are closed. Your doors are closed. And Satan knows why. Because you receive this. Devil is speaking louder than God. You see? That one is smaller than me. That one can't deliver me. That one like that. Devil is talking. And if you reach that level, you are listening to Satan. But if you want to be delivered, I'm ready to be delivered. Let me lift my hands. If there's anything, search for me. Because my deliverance is my new level. So I see you to a new level. I see you to a new level. I've been seeing this. I can give you an example. If, come. Look when I touch this man like this. This man is a prophet. You know why he does like this? It doesn't mean that you have got a demon. Because his heart is open. So there's no way that he won't receive something. But when we touch you, it's like there's pukumatambo in you. It's like there's a rock on you. When you touch here, the reason why you can't receive, your eyes are there. What if I fall? What about my members? What about? Were you born with those members? You are here for yourself. Can I prophesy you and give you a word this week?